It's Friday. I changed this over to 4K 30p because that's how I would want to be shooting my vlogs, and that's why I went ahead and did it this way. I'm going to change to 1080 for a couple shots just for my own use, but this is how I would want to shoot. I'm shooting on the Panasonic FZ2500. I'm headed out right now to go. I'm just testing out for vlogging. I don't think what I did was I went ahead and bought the Panasonic G85 kit from B&H. So I was looking, and I did a bunch of more searches on YouTube and stuff, and found out that that kit is actually better for vlogging. Now this FZ2500 has a longer lens, so it's better for those long shots, but I can just pick up a long lens for the other one. The problem is I can't make this one wider. So this one can't get wider no matter what I do, unless I put some kind of adapter to make it super wide, but then it loses focus, it's not as sharp, and you're using some kind of adapter on the lens. I'd rather have either a wide lens or a long lens. If I have to compromise in one way or the other, then I'd rather have to compromise on having to add a long lens. So on the G85, I can just add a long lens for those long telephoto shots that I need. So there's that. But I am gonna go ahead and do my review of vlogging with the FZ2500 today. I'm driving from Jacksonville, Florida to Atlanta, Georgia. To actually north of Atlanta, about an hour north, so it's gonna take me a little while. Hold it. That's the other thing, is if you remember, I talked about how this one wasn't wide enough. So the face detect works. It seems to be getting my face pretty good. I'm looking over at the screen instead of looking at you. I need to be looking at you guys. Let me turn down this AC. It's cold. You're in Florida. When you're in Florida, you have to have the AC on all the time. That's just the people are like, I've watched my other friends, and they post photos and videos of snowmen. Like just a couple weeks ago, a friend of mine in New Jersey posted like the snowman's melting. I thought, snowman's melting? I'm in Florida, man. it hasn't been cold in here. We had like a week of cold weather, and then it wasn't cold enough to snow. All right. So while not the best position to have the camera in, it's down here on my console on this little pod, so I can put two hands on the wheels and drive. I want to talk about some things. This is like, look at my chin in this damn camera, because I'm looking down. Because I'm looking down, it looks like I'm like... So anyway. So anyway, what I want to talk about today was... I shoot with, you know, if you watch the channel, I shoot with Nikons, and I shoot with Sony, and I shoot with Panasonic. I started shooting with a Panasonic back when I was shooting with video cameras, when DSLRs, when the 5D Mark II, I think it was, the Canon 5D Mark II came out. When the 5D Mark II came out, everybody went bananas over it, started shooting with it. And I liked the look, but I didn't like the 12-minute time limit. And I didn't like that it wasn't very good as far as... It was good. The footage looked fantastic on it. But the image quality was fantastic from a full-frame sensor. But the files were ginormous. It wasn't a very efficient codec. The codec that was on it wasn't very efficient. And... And I didn't have any Canon glass, so I'd have to buy lenses for it. At a 12-minute time limit, so I had to go back and keep hitting record on it. It wasn't for me. I was looking for something that was a little bit better user-wise for video, not necessarily better quality. The quality could be close, but better user-wise, and that's when I found the Panasonic GH1. The Panasonic GH1 had just come out, and I was shooting, my favorite camera at the time back then, well, years before then, was the DVX-100. I had a DVX-100, DVX-100A. So I had one of those, and I really liked the look of Panasonic's. The look and the quality of Panasonic baked-in look, rather than having to edit the look in. Long story short, I ended up getting the GH1. I was in the DVX user forum when Tester 13, his name was Tester 13, but he ended up coming out later as Vitality something, whatever his real name. It's a Russian guy. This Russian guy had hacked the GH1 with a BIOS. You could upgrade the BIOS in the camera by using this hack. And when you upgraded it, it allowed you to put, have higher bit rates and stuff on the camera. I kept telling everybody, I was like, look at the ease of use for this camera. And the funny thing is, back then, it shot on AVC HD, which is nothing but an H.264 codec anyway. It's AVC HD is H.264. All AVC HD did was it had extra information in the folders on the card that would automatically link the multiple clips together. So you had a 4 gig limit on your card for file size based on FAT32 format. The largest file could be 4 gigs. So if you had to shoot an hour long play or something like that, it would every 30 minutes it would make a new file or whatever the bit rate was. So if you had a higher bit rate, it would be like 20 minutes. If you used the lower included bit rate, it'd be like 30 minutes. So every 30 minutes, you'd have a new clip. So if it was an hour and a half play, you'd have 3 clips. So every 30 minutes, so you'd have 3 clips. So in order to make the 3 clips seamless, playback seamlessly, and not look like separate clips, what you would do is you would copy the entire AVC HD structure, file structure, which is the whole private folder on the card, copy that to your computer or drag the files off into the, I would just copy the files. I always just copy the files. I don't do some kind of import thing through the editing software because I don't like where it puts the files. I want to put the files where I want them. People were complaining that the AVC HD codec was a consumer codec because at the time, all the consumer video cameras, the little handheld video palm corders and stuff, shot AVC HD. And they were like, oh, that's a consumer codec. Oh, that's a consumer codec. That's not a professional codec. It's not for editing. It's a consumer codec, because they didn't know how to copy the folders over. You copy the entire folder over, and then you import the folder as an AVC HD, like in Premiere. You pick AVC HD. It will recognize the structure and sync and seamlessly put the 3 files together of your thing. So you drag the 1 down to the timeline, and all 3 come down to the timeline as 1 file. It looks like 1 file in Premiere. That's what the extra information gave you on AVC HD, was the seamless linking of spanning the spanned clips. People were complaining AVC HD is a consumer format, blah blah blah. It's not for professional use, this type of thing. And I didn't care. I was like, call it what you want to. I can set this camera on a tripod, hit record, and walk away from it if I need to, like up in a balcony, and it still gets great footage. Or I don't have to worry about hitting the record button. I can have it facing the bride with a long lens, getting her face during the vows, and I can go over to the other cameras. I can move around and go to the other cameras and shoot those, not have to worry about that one shutting off after, overheating or the time limit being reached or any of that. I can just let it go, like a video camera. It was pretty much like a video camera. Had audio level meters on the screen, and had a flip out LCD that flipped around like this one. And that was a GH1. That was back, 2010 or something like that. Anyway, so I upgraded to the GH2 when it came out, and it had even more hacks from Vitality, Tester 13. And it was fantastic camera too. And then I got a GH3. And then I started shooting more photography, so I got the Nikon, and I got, I picked up this little Sony AX100 that I showed you in the last clip, And that's a fantastic little video camera because I've been shooting on DSLR so long, I bought some Nikons. I'm gonna also do this same test. This tripod, this little GorillaPod thing is sitting on my console, so it's a little bit shaky. I'm gonna do a test with the G85 and the 12. I'm gonna look at this side by side and see which one. I think it's gonna be a wider shot. Hopefully it makes my chin look nicer. I don't think it'll do anything for my chin, but hopefully it's not, you know, we'll see if it's got shaky and whatnot. And I'll put it in the exact same position right here. I see where it is. It's on the park thing and one by the back corner and one over on the other corner. Anyway, I'm going to end up coming back through here and editing this. I'm shooting this at 4K 30p because it's vlog stuff, so I don't care. I usually shoot at 24p, but I'm not trying to be too filmic on this. I'm just trying to do vlogging. So vlogging's fine at 30p. It's a little bit smoother, so I don't look so my chin doesn't look so jittery. Coming back to you. I've got I'm just holding the camera right now. I'm on 75 and there's a ton of traffic. I'll show you. Look at all that traffic. Tons of traffic over here. I skipped over it. Thank goodness for Google. Google Maps and direct, you know, Google driving built into my car stereo. But I was headed up here and it had like an hour delay. And then that changed to like, if I got off, they had a detour, or if you get off or something, because there's construction. As usual, in Atlanta, there's construction. So I'm north of Atlanta, I'm north of Macon. I'm in Forsyth County, Georgia, which is just south of Atlanta. And I hit this congested area, and these people won't let you over. What a bunch of jerks. Anyway, so I just thought I'd do a little quick video. I tapped the focus on myself so that my face would be nice and bright on the camera, on the screen. This camera's pretty heavy holding it out even on this thing. So hopefully maybe the G85 will be lighter, because this thing's still pretty heavy. I'm trying to hold it and it's pretty heavy. I wouldn't want to hold this thing for a long time. It's a pretty heavy camera, especially for vlogging. So anyway, there's that. So sitting in traffic, enjoying it. It's taking me an extra hour to get up here. So instead of 5 hours or 5.5 hours, it's 6.5 hours to get up here, which sucks. So there's that. Oh, and I changed my shirt. You see, I changed my shirt. I had a white shirt on. If you think that I'm in a different thing, it's because I swapped shirts. I just threw that shirt on this morning when I left, and I grabbed this shirt before heading out the door thinking this is the shirt I wanted to wear, not that one. But I didn't feel like changing real quick, so I changed it once I stopped. All right, later. Today's shoot, I'm here at the covered bridge right here. I'm gonna be doing the shoot right here by this bridge under this nice thing. There's a little water, a little walkway over there, over in that way. It's a nice little spot. Let me get my camera gear out, get ready to shoot when they get here.
8:30, 8:15. I had a good shoot, had a good time. You saw the video of me shooting them, getting in the creek and stuff. But anyway, I shot all that on this FZ2500, which is going back this next week. It's headed back. But I'm sending it back because I got the G85. But this is a good camera. I'm not going to lie. This is a really good camera. I'm fixing it. That's a Georgia thing right there. I'm in Georgia and I'm already saying fixing. I'm about to stop off and get something to eat. I'm starving. I haven't eaten anything since this morning when I left. I stopped off and had a steak, egg, and cheese sandwich from Subway, actually, which is kind of cool this morning. The Subway sandwiches, if you get a Subway and you have one of those breakfast places for Subway, you need to stop off and get it, because those things are the bomb, you know. But anyway, so I'm fixing to stop off and grab something fixing. Stop off and grab something to eat. And it's getting too dark to film with, so there's no real reason to keep filming. You can see my focusing going out. It's getting a little dark in here. I'm trying to stay by the light so that you can see me. Anyway, it's been good. It's a pretty good camera. I'll give my final thoughts before I upload this video.
So, I'm going to give you my final thoughts on this camera. I'm recording this right now on the Panasonic FZ2500. This is Sunday. I went out all day Saturday and shot with different things, and I looked at the raw files, the RW2 files from this, and they're not bad. It's actually pretty clean for photography, for photos. I took some pictures. I'm not going to put them on here because they're going to be, I mean, I guess I could put a couple up, but they're raw files. I haven't exported them as JPEG, and I don't feel like re-importing them back into Premiere and stuff. But anyway, as far as the camera goes, it's a pretty good camera. You saw what the footage looked like. The footage is pretty sharp. It had a little trouble in low light on focusing when it was in low light. It seems to be focusing pretty good right now. I'm putting my head right here in the thing. It seems to be focusing good right now on the screen. And I like the little flip-out screen on it. It's nice to have. So you have to have a flip-out screen if you're going to do any kind of vlogging and stuff. So far, it's a pretty good camera. I would recommend the FZ2500, or actually the like I said about the lenses thing at the beginning of this little vlog, if you want one camera that does everything where you don't have to bring a long lens or buy a separate lens or buy a wide lens, and this one's wide enough for you, then this is perfectly fine. This would be a great camera for 99% of the things. If you need that super wide shot, the super wide angle in 4K, this one goes to, I think it's 37 millimeters. So it's not as wide as like some of the others. In 1080p, I believe it's 24, but in 4K, it crops in a little bit, and it's not quite as wide as you'd want it, as I would want it. It was a joy to use, really easy to use. The zoom range is fantastic. It's got an awesome zoom range. The image stabilization, I watched those clips on the image that camera, my camera was bouncing like this. That camera was sitting on the, I was using this is the little gorilla pod type of thing here. I had this little gorilla pod type of tripod. It's a different brand. I was just trying it out. I've got a gorilla pod too, but I bought this and I thought, well, let me try this little one out for something that I could throw in my bag and leave in the bag. And then I can have one, like when I go out on the kayak and stuff like that, or just to have extras of these. So this thing was set up like a tripod, just sitting on my console, where my shifter is in the car. And I mean, I could see the screen bouncing. I could see the screen, the lens hood and the screen were bouncing like this, but the footage, you saw it. When this camera was sitting down and it was like looking up my nose for half of this video, that thing was bouncing, and I was complaining about it bouncing, but it looked pretty stable to me. I mean, I was surprised that it actually looked quite stable. So hand holding it was fine. I took some shots at the zoom end at a slower shutter speed to see what would happen if it would, and they looked perfectly clean and clear. So it's a good little camera. I mean, if you want one where you don't have to worry about changing, like I said, if you don't want to have to worry about changing lenses, You want to be able to record in 4K or 1080p at 60 frames per second or 4K at 30 or 24 frames per second. You want a decent video, a decent stills camera that does your stills, that has a nice touch screen on the back, that does has built-in time lapse, has some really cool nifty little built-in features. This is the camera for you. This is a pretty good camera. Actually, if there wasn't a G85, but that camera wasn't out, the G85, then this would definitely be my first choice for a camera. And if I already didn't have some long lenses, because I've picked up the adapter for Nikon to Micro Four Thirds, so I can throw my 80 to 200 on that G85. There's my long lens. So if I need a long lens, I already have several lenses. I've got a little 50, a nifty 50. It's got a manual aperture on the back. The 80 to 200 has a manual aperture and manual focus. I can do that. It has autofocus, but it's through the little motorized camera. So actually you can, it's mechanical. It's a mechanical focus. It's a heavy duty tack sharp 80 to 200 millimeter Nikon lens. It's a metal lens. They don't make it anymore. I don't think they make it anymore. Anyway, I've got that. I got a 24 to 70. I've got another Canon 50 millimeter with the adapter for Micro Four Thirds. So I already have Micro Four Thirds adapters and lenses and stuff. So I picked up another adapter. But I was going to tell you something, a quick note about B&H. I ordered on Friday, I ordered the G85 from B&H, right? Friday, I was Friday morning. I was like, oh, looking on my phone. I was actually in bed and I was flipping through my phone. I was like, oh, there's that camera from B&H. If I order it now from B&H, they had the G85 in stock. If I order it now, it'll be here in Florida at my house in Jacksonville next Thursday. It said expected shipment, expected arrival time Thursday. So I was like, great, I'll go ahead and order it. So I ordered it. And when I ordered it, they had an option for expedited shipping, paying extra, whatever, 20 or 30 bucks to have 2-day shipping or something like that. And I thought, well, if it's going to be here by Thursday, that's fine. Friday, I have to go back to Atlanta. I'd like to have it for my next trip next weekend. And I'm going to do this exact same thing. Stick the tripod stick the little GorillaPod thing on the dash and do another vlog next weekend and post it next Sunday, hopefully, if I have time. Saturday, I got up and you saw the video earlier of me driving to Atlanta and getting stuck in traffic and all that stuff. And then Saturday when I was leaving when I was coming back down shortly after the last clip that you just saw at night, when I stopped off to eat, I looked up B&H because they didn't send me an email about shipping or anything. So I looked up my account on B&H and it said delivery Friday. Well, if it's delivered on Friday, that's not going to help me. I'm not going to be here on Friday. I'm going to be driving to Atlanta. Their original shipment said Thursday. So I was kind of irritated. I was like, what the heck? Well, maybe I can contact them before. And it said sent to warehouse. So I thought, well, maybe I can contact them and see if I can get them to, I can pay extra for expedited shipping or something to get it here by Thursday. So I shot them off an email on my phone and I didn't hear anything. That was late Saturday night though. So I get up this morning thing and I'm like, well, let me send him another email. Let me go check that. So I checked it and I shot off an email through customer service. A little while later, I get a reply from some guy and he said he checked on the order. He's sorry about that, but he checked on it and it should be here by Thursday. So I was like, well, fantastic. Thanks for checking on it or something like that. And then another one came back and said, we can't change the expert. Somebody else replied too, because I sent two emails. Somebody else said they can't change it. It's already been in there. But the first guy from B&H said it'll be there on Thursday. That's wrong. It should be there Thursday because it's in the warehouse. It's going to ship out of the warehouse on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Thursday is the third day and it should be here on Thursday. So I was like, okay, great. So B&H has excellent customer service. That was on a Sunday. Remember this. It was on a Sunday they contacted me back. So that's great. That's great customer service. And that's why I shop at B&H. And Adorama and B&H are the main places where I shop. And Amazon, obviously. And you'll see the links to Amazon. For any camera gear, though, I usually buy it from B&H or Adorama is where I buy. I think I bought this camera here. I picked up from Adorama, this little camera here. But anyway, so that's my thoughts. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for the one next weekend when I get the G85 and I talk about that. Probably won't post during the week, but you'll see something probably next weekend. Take it easy, YouTube. I'm out.